Good morning, dear students. Welcome to the Narayan and I classes. We'll carry on a discussion about the assignments which have been sent to you. The chapter for today's discussion is body fluids and circulation, and the topic or the subtopic which you are going to discuss today, some of the questions related are to the subtopic formed elements. So question number one, choose the incorrect pair from the following. Number one, histamine, basophil, heparin, secreted by mast cells, hirudin, eosinophils, granules of the formed elements or granular neutrophils. Among this we have to find out which is the incorrect pair. When you see the options carefully, my dear student, we come to understand that histamine and basophil, it is a correct pair. Basophils play an important role in inflammatory reactions. So histamine, basophil is a correct pairing. Heparin, secreted by mast cells. Kindly recall, my dear students, the areolar tissue. The mast cells, they secrete heparin. That also is a correct pairing. Hirudin, eosinophil. Hirudin is an anticoagulant present in the salivary glands of leeches. Eosinophils do not secrete any anticoagulant. So, this pair is not matching. Hirudin, eosinophil. And granular cytoplasm, neutrophils. Among these four choices, number 1, 2 and 4 are correct. The only one which is incorrect is number 3. Hirudin, eosinophil, it is not matching. This is an incorrect pair. Next question. Inflammatory substances are released from which leukocytes? Inflammatory substances are released from which leukocytes? The choices given are number 1, monocyte, basophil, eosinophils, and none of the above. It's a direct question. The inflammatory reactions, basophils play an important role in inflammatory reaction. So correct answer for the second question is choice number 2, basophil. Question number 3, the phagocytic cells with reniform nucleus. This question is about the shape of the nucleus. The phagocytic cells with reniform nucleus is number 1, monocyte, number 2, neutrophils, number 3, eosinophils, and number 4, lymphocytes. Monocytes, these are the phagocytic cells which show a distinct kidney shaped nucleus. That is why they are called, it is called as a reniform shaped nucleus. So the correct answer for question number 3 is monocytes. Monocytes show the presence of a very distinct nucleus which is kidney shaped, hence reniform nucleus. Question number 4. The main function of lymphocytes is? What is the main function of lymphocytes? The choices given are to destroy poisonous substances present in the body, to clot the blood at the site of a wound, to carry oxygen to different parts of the body, to destroy bacteria. Lymphocytes play a very important role in our defense mechanism, in our immunological reaction. So the correct answer for this question is they destroy bacteria. They destroy bacteria. Question number 5. Which of the following formed elements has a bilode shaped nucleus? Among the basophils, eosinophils and neutrophils, they have the nucleus is somewhat distinct. definitely bilob nucleus. The question is about a bilob nucleus is present in number 1 eosinophil, number 2 monocyte, number 3 neutrophil, and number 4 lymphocytes. We all know, my dear students, a distinct bilobed nucleus is present in eosinophil. So the correct answer is eosinophil. Next question. The non-granulatory white blood corpuscles are, my dear students, we all know that WBCs are classified into granular and non-granular. Granulocytes, agranulocytes, on the basis of the presence and absence of a granular cytoplasm. The non-granulatory white blood corpuscles are, the options given are basophil, eosinophils and neutrophils. Basophil and monocytes. Choice number 3, eosinophils and lymphocytes. Choice number 4, B and T lymphocytes and monocytes. Among the options given, my dear student, it's very clear that agranulocytes are the beta lymphocytes and T lymphocytes and monocytes. So among the given options, the correct option is option number 4. Basophil, eosinophil and neutrophils are granulocytes. Basophil and monocyte, these are granulocytes, these are agranular. So the correct option is B and T lymphocytes and monocytes. These are agranulocytes. Next question. Which of the following set belongs to granulocytes of the blood? That question was about non-granulocyte. This question is about granulocyte. The cells having a granular cytoplasm. The choices given are number 1 eosinophil, basophil, neutrophil, lymphocytes, monocytes and basophil. Choice number 3 basophil, monocytes and eosinophils. Choice number 4 basophil, lymphocytes and neutrophils. When you go carefully through all the given options, clearly we come to know that eosinophils, basophils and neutrophils are granulocytes. This set number 1 is a complete representation of granulocytes of the blood. So the correct option is option number 1. Next question. Mark among the following a cell which does not exhibit phagocytic activity. Among the various WBCs, some are involved in allergic reaction, some are involved in phagocytic activity, some are involved in inflammatory activity. So the question here is, which of the following, the question is, mark among the following a cell which does not exhibit phagocytic activity. The choices given are monocytes, neutrophil, basophil, macrophages. Except basophil, all the cells, monocytes, neutrophils and macrophages, they exhibit phagocytic activity. But basophils only exhibit inflammatory functions. They exhibit inflammatory activity. So, among the following, which does not exhibit phagocytic activity is basophil. Okay? The next question. The cells involved in inflammatory reaction. A continuation of the question number 8. There it was, which exhibit phagocytic. Here it is, the cells involved in inflammatory reaction. Already I explained you, it will be a repetition. When we go through the choices, we see that the cells involved in inflammatory reactions are the basophils. Are the basophils. Neutrophils, eosinophils, lymphocytes, they have other functions. Basophils are involved in inflammatory reactions. Next question in this assignment. Question number 10. Thrombocytopenia is, the options given are excess production of WBC, less number of platelets. Number 3, excess number of platelets. Number 4, less production of WBC. thrombocytopenia. Thrombocytes, my dear students, you know, thrombocytes are nothing but the platelets. They should have a certain count. You all know about 1.5 lakh to 3.5 lakh per cubic mm of blood. So a condition in which the count of the platelets fall down in a person, that condition is called thrombocytopenia. Now coming to our question, among the options given, thrombocytopenia is less number of platelets. If the platelet count is less, that condition is called thrombocytopenia. Question number 11. Leukopenia, this is also a condition. Leukopenia is more production of WBC, more production of RBC. Option number 3, excess platelets. Option number 3, excess platelets. Option number 4, less production of WBC. So leukopenia, WBC count also, my dear students, you know, it should be in a normal person, it is around 6000 to 8000 cells per cubic mm of blood. If it is less than this, that condition is called leukopenia. So among the given options, the correct option is less production of WBC is called leukopenia. Question number 12, diapedesis. A type of flagellar movement. Movement of some WBC to tissue through the wall of the blood capillaries to destroy harmful bacteria. Number 3, relaxation of heart chamber. Number 4, filtration process of urea and kidney. Diapedesis. It has been explained in the class very well, my dear students, that the WBCs, they move out of the cell wall of the blood capillaries, and their movement is an amoeboid movement. Just as an amoeba moves, they move in that type of movement and they destroy the bacteria which are present. So diapedesis is referred to as the amoeboid movement of some WBC to tissue through the wall of the blood capillary to destroy harmful bacteria. So among the given options, the correct answer is choice number 2. Okay?